Thank you so much. All right. Way more people than I expected, but let's do it. How Amazon Bedrock is helping the next generation of AWS builders. This is a topic for today, so hopefully you're in the right place. And for the next 15 minutes, we're going to be discussing my personal journey, honestly, from not even knowing what Amazon Bedrock was, all the way up to building tools that is currently helping the AWS community already. My name is Rafael Bocchino. I'm a senior solution engineer at Snyk, which pretty much means I work really closely to my customers, making sure that they are building securely in AWS. But when I'm not helping them build securely, I'm actually building in AWS myself, right? I'm also an AWS community builder, so I put articles out there, videos out there, and I'm also a user group leader for the Dallas, Texas region. Anybody from Dallas here? Cool, we need to chat later because I haven't seen your faces in the user group yet, and I'm going to drag you there. And whenever I'm not in my computer or not with the community that my wife dragged me out of the computer, I'm usually with her doing hikes, climbing nowadays, playing with my dogs, cooking, and as a really good Brazilian should, watching soccer. All right. By the way, you're going to see a bunch of pictures today. All those pictures were generated using Amazon Bedrock, and you can see the input that I provided to generate the picture right below it, right? And before we start, I want to do some expectation setting. This is a 101 kind of session, right? This is really basic, so I will do a bunch of oversimplification of topics because the goal here, it isn't about getting out of this room knowing a bunch of about Amazon Bedrock or the LLM Gen AI technologies. It's about getting inspired, right? So don't expect code. Except for this slide. This slide has code. That's the only one, I promise. Have you seen these before? Yes? Why? Because you're using Amazon Code Whisper, right? Amazon Code Whisper is Gen AI helping us become better coders. Not builders, coders. And that's part of the story. Save that information. Have you seen those before? All these news articles, apocalyptical, saying that tomorrow we are out of jobs because AI is going to replace us. We are doomed. Right? We keep seeing those. The thing, though, is, and the reason why I'm here today, I refuse to believe in this future. I refuse to believe that AI is going to take over. I truly believe that there is a future where Gen AI, like Amazon Bedrock, can actually make us better builders, better human beings. So Code Whisper is awesome, but that's just part of the answer. I wanted to know, combining my desire to prove myself that the future can be better than those articles with Amazon Bedrock, can I prove myself that the future can be better? Small challenge, though. What is Amazon Bedrock? AI, Gen AI, LLM, RAG, or whatever the new hot thing is. I honestly didn't know the first thing about any of those at all. So if I'm trying to use Amazon Bedrock to create a better future, but I don't even know what Amazon Bedrock is, that's a slight challenge, right? But what I lacked in knowledge, I had in desire, in ideas to make this happen, okay? So for the rest of this presentation, we're going to be discussing problems that I was trying to solve and how I tackled them and what was the outcome. Deal? Cool. So problem number one. I created this super awesome, neat AWS Step Functions workflow that I was super excited about. I was so excited that I wrote an article about it. I published, I had people comment on it. I was even more excited until I read a comment that said, there's a service for that. No, I spent like hours and hours and hours of my life to make that happen. just to find out that was a waste of my time. There was a service for that already. Anybody had a similar problem in the past? Yeah, reinventing the wheel? Yeah. And I didn't even know that was happening. So I guess that's a common problem, right? There are so many services out there, 200 plus, 300 plus, I don't even know anymore. How do we know more about them? How do we get to know those services that already exist? Yeah, it's a challenge to keep up with what's going on here, everything what is new, but what about what is out there already? So I thought, how can AI help me with that problem? So I decided to build something. And I thought, what if there was a bot that sends me a daily reminder of an interesting fact about an AWS service? Right? Well, a daily reminder of something on an existing AWS service can be helpful, not just for me, but hopefully for the average AWS builder, for the community. The challenge, though, like I said before, is I don't know the first thing about AI. How can I use AI to build this robot? But if there is one thing that I know how to do is how to open the AWS dashboard. It's easy, right? I went to the AWS dashboard. I found the Amazon Bedrock icon. I clicked it. There was some kind of playground thing there. And there was this page where I could enter a prompt, and it would answer me back. OK, let me use that then to solve this problem. That seems easy enough. So first thing that I did was, my prompt was, give me a list of the top 10 most popular AWS services. And if you're a Brazilian like me, or if you speak Portuguese, you're going to realize that I misspelled list with the Portuguese version of list. And even then, Amazon Bedrock understood, so the thing is good. And it gave me a list of the services. Cool. My follow-up prompt was then, for each of those, generate 50 interesting facts following this specific CSV format. By the end of it, I had 500 different interesting facts in a CSV format. So I got that file, I added it to a bucket, and I had this rule that every day, 10 a.m. Central, it would trigger this Lambda function. This Lambda function picks one randomly, writes that as a JSON into a bucket, and whenever that put file happens, two Lambdas are triggered to publish that information to two different social medias. One has, or used to have, a little birdie on it. And that's it. The outcome is that. Now, every day, I receive a tweet, a message from the bot that is telling me about a service, right? Well, what is this service and an interesting fact about this service? And there are some followers already that are benefiting from this bot as well, which is awesome. But that was problem number one. Another challenge is, and especially if you're here this week, you know this, AWS releases a lot of stuff all the time, right? From new services to new features for existing services and everything in between, there is so much that you need to learn about AWS all the time, right? Does anybody have a challenge in keeping up with AWS releases? OK, good. I'm not the only one. So helpful for the community as well. Some of you might think, I have the answer. Have you heard about the What's New page on AWS? Yes, I did. But there is a challenge there as well. Look at this list of new news articles in the What's New on AWS. All of those, exact same day. There are 12 here, and it's just because I couldn't fit everything in this slide. So many entries for any given day, and that was pre-reinvent. Try to go there right now. That would be hundreds, I'm sure. So yeah, I could go and read every single one of them, but that would be challenging, right? I wish I had that much time. I really wish. So then I thought, what if there was a bot that sends me a summary of each one of those articles as they are released? Challenge is now, yes, I use Amazon Bedrock, but through their UI, for this, for sure, I need to learn how to use its API, right? So I created this news bot. And it's a Python application that every 5 minutes, if I remember correctly, it fetches the RSS feed from that What's New page. It's going to check if there are any new article. And for each one of those, it's going to use Amazon Bedrock API to summarize that article in a tweet form. And it's going to publish that information. So, and what I did actually was really simple. I got, it's pretty much the same thing as going to the UI and asking Amazon Bedrock something like this. Pretend you're a helpful AWS assistant. I'm going to give you this article. Please summarize this article in a tweet form, right? So with all the limitations of a tweet. And it did. It actually did. So now, instead of keeping up with that page, I subscribe to this bot that is daily. It's actually, anytime there's a news entry there, it sends a summarized version of that article. And in its thread, a link to the actual article. So I read that summary. If it is interesting enough, I go and click that link. Super, super helpful as well. Now I need to invest less time to learn what's new about AWS. And hopefully, the average AWS builder, the community, can do the same. But something that I learned while trying to solve this problem too here was the following. Of course, the first thing that I did trying to learn Amazon Bedrock was what? To go to Amazon Bedrock and ask, teach me Amazon Bedrock, right? Of course I was going to do that. Challenging though, because Amazon Bedrock is so new that Amazon Bedrock didn't know about itself. And so I tried to reach out to somebody to ask questions about this, but Amazon Bedrock was so new that there wasn't that many specialists out there yet. So I couldn't even reach out to a friend or a peer to help me. So I thought, hey, maybe there is an application here for AI. Maybe AI can help me with this. And by the way, I had to bring this up. When I asked Amazon Bedrock how to use Amazon Bedrock, it brought up some really interesting things like download and install Bedrock server software. What? There is something here really cool. Let me see. Da-da-da. Where is it? Use the Minecraft Marketplace to install new content. What? Minecraft Marketplace? What the heck are you talking about, Amazon Bedrock? Yeah, I could play something right now. I really could, but I'm trying to build this. So, okay. The challenge now is here. If Amazon Bedrock doesn't know about Amazon Bedrock, how can Amazon Bedrock help me learn more about Amazon Bedrock? So the idea here was, if there was a bot that was a specialist in a certain AWS topic, like Amazon Bedrock, that could answer all my questions. But again, clearly Amazon Bedrock, at least at first, couldn't help me with that. The thing, though, is the problem wasn't Amazon Bedrock itself. Amazon Bedrock is awesome. LLMs are incredible, but they have limitations. They are trained up to a certain point with certain data, right? So if you're asking questions that are about a topic that is too recent or too specific, they simply don't know the answer for, and they can keep giving you these really weird answers like we saw before. So this isn't an Amazon Bedrock limitation. This is an LLM limitation. But there is an answer to fixing that problem and actually being able to use LLM or Amazon Bedrock to help me. It is called RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation. These three really fancy words combined pretty much means the following. The LLM is going to retrieve data from outside the LLM itself, so outside of the Amazon Bedrock scope. It's going to use that data to augment the user's prompt, and it's going to add that relevant retrieved data to the user's response, to the user's answer. What does that mean? So I actually had two processes in place here. one for ingestion and one for consumption. The ingestion is really simple. Python code that had access to the Amazon Bedrock user guide PDF, right? And there's something called a splitter function. It pretty much goes through the PDF and it creates chunks. It splits it in chunks of text. And there's a process called embedding. Embedding, it's a really complicated process, but simplifying it is a math function that runs against that chunk of data, and it generates a position in that array for every single one of those chunks. The closer they are, the more related they are. The further away they are, the less related they are. And then I save all this into OpenSearch. Then there is the consumption. Whenever I'm asking a question as a user to this bot, I'm going through this process. So I have the user query that is going to also have the embedding generated for that query using Amazon Bedrock. And because now I know how related to this, all this data that I have and this user provided input, I know what the answer is for that question. So I get that answer from the database with that information. I augment that information with Amazon Bedrock LLM, and then I finally provide an answer to the user. So what we had before talking about Minecraft actually makes sense now. When I ask the same question after going through this process, I have an answer that says stuff like, if you don't have an AWS account, first thing you should do is create one. Yeah, that makes sense. It goes through the entire process to start using Amazon Bedrock. What my main goal here today was to show you, to prove to myself that the future is limitless, right? We shouldn't worry about AI replacing our jobs. We should be worrying about how we can leverage AI to make a better future for ourselves. I know that I have a ton to do already. After I learned RAG, I realized that I could use RAG to make the two previous bots more intelligent, more smarter with that information. I also start creating a bot where I can ask, I can describe AWS infrastructure, and it generates a diagram for me. And the next stage would be to actually generate the CDK or the CloudFormation. But what I really want to know is, after this conversation, what else? What ideas do you have of how we can together build a better future for the next generation of AWS builders? The one message that I want to leave you with you today is that I truly believe that the future can and will be better than today. Again, my name is Rafael Bottino. Thank you so much for your time today. We had a really short time, but I would love to, not right now because we don't have time, but outside, take any questions that you have, any comments that you have, and I would love to hear your ideas for how we can use Amazon Bedrock to make a better future for the next generation of AWS builders. Thank you so much for your time.